Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to GameStar TV. We are just about ready to bring you the next match of the evening. It is going to be 0.1 hit ratio. I like to call them the 10 percenters versus the Mighty Ducks. And if we have a quick look over at the brackets, you can see that these are the top seeds, number one and number two seed for the tournament. They are in the technical winners bracket. So we are in for a cracker of a match. My name is Chrisis. I'm joined once again by Byza. And boy, we are looking forward to this match, Byza.
Oh, we've had a treat in the previous match, and if you think that was good, well, we're gonna be delighted by the action of what these teams can provide to us. 0.1 hit ratio taking on the Mighty Ducks. This is set up for an epic battle, Chrisis.
It's going to be a good one. We've got on the blue team 0.1 hit ratio. That's Aurocrow, Dumbo, and Kawaii Neko Waifu, who I think we're just going to call Kawaii for the rest of the evening. And on the orange team, we got Two-Face, Schnoots, and Zira representing the Mighty Ducks.
Indeed. So this is the Cyber Gamer main, the Plantronics Pro Action.
Aurocrow!
And holy mackerels. The first goal. We've seen that a lot tonight, Chrisis, but the first goal there, easy by Aurocrow, right at the back. He's actually hit the roof. Jagged it in. And both of the defenders hit each other, so
wow.
Not a good start there by the 10 percenters, but the Mighty Ducks, oof, that wasn't good defense by them as they clash with each other. Let's jump back onto the action right now, and Xera trying to work it out for his team. Dumbo working it back into an attacking shot. Schnutz works it out to the side. Defending for the Mighty Ducks, and your big long name word, which we're going to call, what are we going to call?
Kawaii.
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 Yeah.
Okay, Kawaii.
And when you say it, you've got to tilt your head and hold up the V sign and go Kawaii.
Kawaii.
Kawaii. Maybe wear one of those flowery dolls dresses. That'd work.
Yeah, indeed. Guys, you got any shout outs tonight? Chuck them in the Twitch chat. EJ's monitoring at the moment. Give us your best hashtag.
Oh, shot on goals. Right, Two-Face. Two-Face comes through.
A goal.
Hashtag update the bracket.
Oh, yeah. Hashtag update the bracket, which hasn't been updated just yet. But that's okay. We've got our scoreboard updated. That was the thing that delayed us the most, was getting that working. And straight away, within 1 minute, completely different to the previous semi-final that we had, or quarter-final, what was it? It wasn't really a quarter-final, but not a semi-final either. We've had two goals within the first minute, and one from each of these two teams. So, not even a chance to kind of get ourselves warmed up into it, Byza. We've got two goals already.
Two goals already, and that's what the boys really want, just to get their confidence set. Look, we're the best of seven tonight, so we're in for the long haul. And both of these teams can perform and put the goals in the back of the net. So it'll be really interesting to see how they set. I do believe the nerves are calmed right now. I think they might have checked out the last game and they've warmed up to that. But both of the teams set up for a big one right here, Chrisis.
Yeah, they are indeed. We're with Zera right now. He's on defense in his own zone. Joust with Aurocrow, anticipates it well and gets a touch of the ball. He's probably going to be running low on boost. Collects a little bit there, then gets a full tank after that, but Dumbo now with the control on the ball. Good interception from Two-Face in the midfield, but it's cleared away, and now danger in the orange zone. A shot on goals defended by Schnutz is what they need on the Mighty Ducks to keep the scores dead even. But the ball is sitting in the orange zone for quite some time now, Byza, as the pressure mounts for the Mighty Ducks.
A clear out here from Mighty Ducks. Two-Face following it, but it gets defended out by the Kawaii. As I turn my head and hold up my fingers, Dumbo tries to set out for his team. Schnutz waiting for it, almost has a shot on goal, but it gets cleared out. Now an aerial dispute puts it back down into the center. Kawaii works it out to the side, almost a shot on goal, but not accurate enough for his team. And it sits high as the joust from Two-Face. Doesn't really set it anyway, but he's good enough to get back around and hit the opposition player out of the way from doing anything with the ball. Now he's up following it with the boost straight into the Aurocrow, so there's nothing really happening here for the Mighty Ducks.
Nice little piece of control there, but it's almost a pass to Dumbo, who takes another shot at goals. It's cleared away. Orocrow gets up into the air. He gets a second touch on the ball that he set up for himself, but it's cleared away again. And right now, all over the field, the ball is going back and forth as these two teams get the feel for each other in the first game of the best of seven series. They're getting themselves in. Schnutz gets a touch to the ball, sets it up for Zero, who whiffs it. But the goal face is open, and Two-Face takes advantage, seals the deal, and goes 2-1 up for his team. The Mighty Ducks.
Oh, nicely done there. Pretty much took that from the back end, saw an opportunity and took it there. It's very nicely done. 2-1 on the scoreboard. Let's get excited about this crisis, because this is some a ripper action right now.
Yeah, Dumbo touches the ball, sends it over to Orocrow, who gets the deflect. Oh, the defense is good from Schnutz. He picks up a halo. Absolutely vital that he did that. Dumbo keeps the ball in range, though. It's going to bounce off. Oh! The angle is good, but it's right at a defender, and Schnutz gets the easiest halo he's ever earned in his life as the ball flies straight at him, and he gets the defense out. It's now back over into the blue zone, and can Two-Face get a hat-trick? He scored both of the goals for the orange team. The Mighty Ducks, there's a shot that goes a little bit wide. The clear out, great demo from Kawhi, Waifu. And a great touch from Dumbo.
That's a tough shot, Crisis. You've got to work the angle and hit it on the way down. Dumbo's gone up early, read it perfectly. Almost a full 360 in the process and slotted in. That is a really good goal there. There's another contention for you tonight, EJ.
And that assist from Kawhi was fantastic, carrying the ball fast up the side, getting a demo to clear a defender away, and still getting the cross in for Dumbo to get the beautiful goal, which was the icing of the cake from that move. Dumbo, we've been sticking with him. He's up in the air, gets a little bit of a juggle going. Zero with the disruption, keeps the ball in the midfield, and that's a shot from the midfield. Two-Face gets his hat-trick onto the board. Man, he is carrying his team right now, and his back is well strong as he beats Orocrow there in the goals. 3-2 with 33 seconds remaining on the clock.
0.1 hit ratio, need to set up the defense a little bit better there. I can't even think of the word I want to say, but just taking the long shots and not able to stop them just says the defense is not really set up yet there, Crisis.
Just having a very quick check out there, guys, and switching, interlacing off. I think if we haven't had any complaints about it yet, we should have done, because for some reason, the capture card was doing all sorts of weird interlacing. 4 seconds to go. This is a long-range shot from the Mighty Ducks. Schnutz keeping it in the right zone. That's the blue one to make sure that there's no overtime from the 10%ers. And the Mighty Ducks take the bull by the horns and get themselves in the lead in the first game of the best of seven.
Really well done there. Sorry, mate.
Hope the Twitch chat is keeping an eye on the players and looking for an MVP. A quick shout out from who was it?
Quick shout out to Aaron for subbing, by the way. Love you a long time, Aaron. Woo, get some.
Who's he subbing? What's his in-game name?
No, subscription to us. Love you.
Oh, subscribing to us. Oh, fantastic. Did the sub emote work?
Dakota Weber says he's not subbing into My Face is Available.
Hey, dude, whatever you want to fap to, we'll put up for you. It's not a problem. Oh, Plantronics.
I was saying to you earlier, when's My Face going to go up? Well, there's a contention. Dakota.
Yeah, that's Aaron. He'll
subscribe.
Shout out to Starkiller, who reckons that Schnutz for game one was looking good for MVP.
Now, I wonder if you're doing that on purpose. The way it's pronounced is Schnutz. And you're going Schnutz.
Schnutz. Is it Schnutz?
All right. Well, it's Schnutz.
Kawhi Neku, as we tilt our heads to the side of one and show the V sign.
Put the fingers up. There we are.
Puts the 10%ers on the board. In fact, he's even got the little heart. That's fantastic. I'm loving Kawhi Neku Waifu. I wonder if he plays that game with the cats, Neko Katsumi. Neko Atsumi is the game with the Cats.
It'd be you and him, and only it'd be you and him only who would play that game, because I have no idea what you're talking about. But that's a good start by 0.1 hit ratio, and it's what they needed. Look, we're gonna have to see a couple more goals from them tonight, because it looks like we're seeing a highly offensive strategy plays by both teams. So they can't stop at the one goal, but here comes the second, and it's the same, man. Put your fingers up, because that is the Kawhi. And Oroko, with the beauty of a set, the play out from Schnatz, well, he just gave it straight to Kawhi, and that was an opportunity that was never going to be passed by.
Yeah, Kawhi with a great powerful thrust on that ball. He's the man who has to take the center as well. It's unfortunately not a good one for them. Nicely set up into the blue zone for the comeback for Mighty Ducks to begin. If they can just get a touch to it, zero is the one, and he does it. Well, it was a piece of hard work that he has to do. Carry it in front of the goals. In fact, Kawhi set it up for him. Gifted it to Zira, who takes advantage of the pop-up from Kawhi and gets his team to eat a donut and score one onto the board. 4 minutes and 13 seconds to go, and it has been fast-paced action from the get-go, Byza.
Yeah, plenty of goals scored as well. So we're looking at a high-scoring game from both of these teams compared to the last match, which is pretty tight action and low-scoring. So it'll be interesting to see how the rest plays out. A pass from Xero sets up Schnatz, but is in the wrong place and can't score defense from the 0.1 hit ratio, proving well as they work into the attack. Half switches over. Aurora Crow was stalking, but he decided to leave it. Two-Face will hit out for the Ducks. Schnatz on the side, setting it down. He's wanting Two-Face to come through, but he hasn't moved into the right position, so a clear will come. But Xero will say nothing to that. He wants it to be set. Here comes the shot. Oh, just cleared out by Dumbo, and it's lovely there, but it's coming back around. Two-Faced sets it up, goes Xero, pushes it into the side. Almost a setup goal there, Chrisis, but nothing really setting. As Two-Faced gets into the dangerous spot, Aurora, an easy clear, but the back comes over the top, and it's just saved by the Kawhi. Very nicely done by the 0.1 hit ratio, but what we're seeing is their defense under the fire as the Mighty Ducks go flying in the V.
Yeah, they're trying real hard to get it in. They've been peppering the goal face with attempts at goals, but nothing going in there. It's either been wide, high, or successfully defended, but they're keeping the pressure on. The ball doesn't stay out of the blue zone for long, and this is another shot that goes high. Xero just gets a center credit. Doesn't actually get a shot on goals credit even there. Now Kawhi gets a touch on the ball, gets it over into the center. Three defenders up for it though. And it is not to be, just 2-1 the goal. And it's kind of like the run of play of the first game again, where in the first minute we had so many goals scored, and then all of a sudden it goes a little bit quieter and the team seem to lose their targets.
It tightens up, Chrisis. The converted a lot of the goals. Look at that, right, let's put defense in play, let's tighten this up. And you've got one team on hand trying to score, the other team keeping it out. It just goes back and forth right now.
It does indeed. It's sitting in the orange zone right now for the boys on the 10 percenters to get a ball in. There's another shot. It's gone wide yet again. Kawhi gets a touch to it to keep it in the orange zone. But can somebody put the ball away? Yes, they can. It is Oro Crow who comes through for his team after so many missed attempts from the Mighty Ducks. The boys from 10%. Get the ball into the orange zone and take one, two shots, and the third is all it takes for the ball to go in. They are 3-1 in the lead now, Byza, and looking very, very strong to reply to the Mighty Ducks' first game victory.
Tough game for the Ducks here. EJ, how's the social media going at the moment, mate?
Yeah, pretty good, dude. I just watched a kitten fall off when trying to jump from a chest to a blind
Hold on that one, because Xero comes from the side and says, I'm going to have a lovely shot. In fact, no, that was the Two-Face who hit it into the thing. But have a look at that. Second touch up by Xero. Finishes it off. Brings their side a little bit, wee bit back. But with just a minute to go and the one behind, it's going to be close here, Chrisis.
Yeah, 3-2 is the score right now. as the boys from the Mighty Ducks look to create at the very least an overtime situation. If not, in a minute you could score another goal, but the goal face is wide open and Kawhi gets himself a nice little tilt of the head from the casters and the Twitch chat alike as he gets his hat trick up on the board, Byza.
Look, Schnatz was coming up to get some aerial work off the side, and then he realized, oh crap, I'm in the wrong place, and called out Kawhi with an easy goal. Well, you're a good player, you put them in pretty much 99.9% of the time. Here comes Xera with a dribble out of the middle. It gets bounced back off Schnatz, waiting for it. They've got to work it right now. The Ducks, if they're going to be in contention of even drawing this match out, they pop it up. Two-Face sets down to the side, up goes Schnatz, but he misses it in the process, hits it off the side. Dumbo following it up and we're trying to pop to his teammate Rorico. Oh, knows he's caught out. He's
backfired.
Done the loop and Schnatz has converted. Look, Chrisis, that's dangerous, just passing back, but he was caught out. He knew that it was not going to really be, even if he went, it was going to be scored against him, and just doing the loop caught him. That's a good goal by the Mighty Ducks. With 37 seconds left remaining, there's still a chance for him.
Yeah, one goal is all it's going to take for them to even up the scores. Two-Face, Xera and Schnatz are working together to create that for themselves. They're 1-0 up. That's an angle that's just too wide. Two-Face thought he'd done it, but now the defense or the moves from Kawhi in the midfield in front of his goal, in fact, now carrying it up, gets a demo. This is how he created the last goal. In fact, getting a demo, carrying it up the left-hand side. But the countdown now is happening as the ball sits in the orange zone. It's now floating around in that midfield, and it is not going to be an overtime situation for the Mighty Ducks. And the 10%ers pull one back and even up the round scores 1-1.
Now, EJ, sorry, mate, we had you halfway in the chat before, and then we cut you off. How's it looking at the moment?
Well, Super Roach is having a good time. He's enjoying it. Outside of that, there's a lot of quacking going on, so I presume that's a lot of duck support.
Yeah, a lot of duck support.
But they didn't quite come back in that one, so they're going to have to pull it out in the third round if they're going to keep the fan base and myself happy.
All right, we're into game number 3. It's a best of 7. It's the Plantronics Pro League. It's here on GameStar TV 1. And my name is Chrisis. And I'm joined by Byza for has been a cracker of an evening so far. We've got a lot more Rocket League to come. And right now, the Mighty Ducks and the 10%ers are neck and neck. They are exactly even all the way across the border. Floating ball that goes by Schnutz.
Lovely stuff.
Gets the defense there. Schnutz, if you want to call him that. The Twitch chat has been pointing out that Schnutz rhymes with shoots, so maybe I should call him that when he's on offense.
Oh, Dumbo! Almost with a goal save or clear on that behalf. I think that was a save. It does set back up here for the 10% is, or the 0.1 hit ratio, however you want to call them. They're doing very well with the attacking right now. Dumbo sets it up and hits off the wall with a follow-up. It goes over the top of Two-Face. He's caught out in the wrong position. He tries to reset. Up comes Ororoko. It's a little bit weak, so it gives Two-Face the opportunity to clear. Dumbo now putting in the attacking. Two-Face once again. Double plays from both players working out for both teams. Really setting the pace right now, and this is intense. I think right now, Chrisis, that this game has gone up a gear.
Yeah, things have turned around because this time it is the boys in blue, 0.1 hit ratio, who are peppering the goal face this time. Not finding it just yet as the donuts stay on the board, and I just switched away from Kawhi Neko Waifu, and he gets a point on the board.
We have to find an emoji in the Twitch stream that has a head tilted to the side, because that's what you're doing, then you're going to have the flying V. Kawhi with a shot, lovely play there. He puts 0.1 hit ratio in front, and it's a good start by them as they pick up the last game and probably put a little bit of doubt in the Ducks' mind, but it's early games of the series, so plenty of time for the teams to make amends. Right now the ball's sitting in the corner. Schnutz coming out to try and hit the ball out, but Dumbo hits the top of the goal mouth there. And it sits to the side. It's just a little bit of a lingo as they tango around and try to sort out what they want to do with the ball. still sitting in the defensive half for the Ducks. All the pressure on here right now, Chrisis.
Yeah, lots and lots of attempts to set things up, but it's going to turn around on them. Two-Face picks up the ball and against the run of play, eases the pressure instantly on the Mighty Ducks with a shot into the far left-hand corner. He had to do it to beat Dumbo, who was flying across on defense. And that is the scores evened up for the Mighty Ducks. They'll be pleased with that. 3 minutes of play to go. And the scores dead even. Now the ball sitting up in the air. Nobody really wants it, though. Nobody goes to fetch it. And Dumbo picks it up just as it reaches the ground. He's not really created anything out of it. That's a little pinch that goes across from Kawhi. It's staying in the orange zone. And that's been the story of the game so far. The orange zone is where the ball likes to stay. And, oh, it's dangerous sitting in front of the orange goal. Nuts. Just defended by Zach.
What is Nuts done? He's just crossed that over, and that was almost a goal opportunity for... oh, my goodness. Well, that's a lucky... That's the Ducks off right there. They're very lucky that they did not go in. However, they're still in defensive right now. Dumbo trying to sit around the side, does a double tap into the wall, and does absolutely nothing for his team. Oroko will follow up and try to set. It goes high, out goes Schnutz with a side push. Dumbo hits it up, has an opportunity for Xera to fly. He's up, he sets it, hits the top, and drops down right in front of the goal. It's an opportunity for a goal. Aurora just saving for his team, which potential goal for the Ducks, and they could have been up here, but now setting up Dumbo down the side. Out goes the Kawhi, just misses the ball. Two-Face will come out for the Ducks and clear. The Aurora will stop anything from going into the attack. Dumbo just saving it back, flips it out. Very lucky he connected there, Chrisis. Because I tell you, if he didn't, that would have been a goal for the Ducks.
Let's see what the orange team can do. It wasn't a goal for the Ducks in the end. They're going to have another shot, though, because Zera is carrying it forward, gets a good cross in, but it's disrupted by the defender. So he switches over to disrupt the goalie duty, knocks somebody around a little bit. Kawhi comes through, though, and gets a good save on there as the ball now moves back into the blue zone. And Kawhi, just after getting the save, has to get back in defense. The ball sitting up right now. Who's going to go for it? It's not going to be Schnutz, so he doesn't get to rhyme with shoots. Just then, Two-Faced coming across the ball, but it's cleared out and back into the blue zone. The Mighty Ducks now on control, now on attack, but it's cleared away. 1 minute remaining, Byza. And who's going to break the deadlock?
It's tough play at the moment. Both teams proving how strong they can be in the and or how fierce they can be attacking, but obviously how strong they are in the defensive pushouts as well. Here comes the shot. However, as Dumbo from the back end slots a long goal assist, or long goal shot himself. Have a look at that. Schnutz is probably living himself because he's the one who hit it off the wall to him. And Xera couldn't do much. And there is your tiebreaker down. Well, we're still in 40 seconds in, but there goes the deadlock in favor of 0.1 hit ratio, and they're doing quite well right now, Chrisis.
They are indeed. Aurora gets up into the air. His the follow-up from Kawhi is good, and then Dumbo flying from behind sets the ball up, and Kawhi Neku almost gets yet another goal. He's been playing fantastically all day long so far. 20 seconds remaining into the orange zone we go, and this is what the 10%ers will want to do, maintain it there. The interception from Dumbo is not quite good enough, just a disruption of the attack, but it's still in the blue zone. This is an opportunity. Two-Face goes up into the air. Zero is there to support him. The countdown reaches zero, and the ball touches the ground, and that is the 10%ers going one more up and 2-1 in the series.
Really, really, really good play by both teams. But what we're seeing is a little bit of a trend. 0.1 hit ratio are coming out with the goods in the end. At the moment, they've got this. They've got the best boost, a really good attacking styles, and the defense is strong. It's a really dangerous combination, and the way they're going, they could just take this and clean it out right now, Chrisis.
Yeah, they've got great momentum. And shout outs to just for the Twitch viewers who are looking at that lovely 0.1 symbol for the 10%ers. That is courtesy of Byza. He put it together for them. So that's just, if you don't like its 0.1 hit ratio, you know what you need to do is design a logo for your esports organization so that we can pimp you guys out properly. It is the Plantronics CGM Finals, the second match of the evening. This is not an elimination final, is it?
No, this is the second opportunity. So the winner goes through to the grand final and the loser goes into the elimination with Elim Gaming. The winner out of that will then face the winner out of this match to get your head around it.
Yeah, heads perfectly around it. Aura Crow gets a good touch in the air, stopping the ball in the midfield, but it's still in control by Two-Face, who takes it up the wall, gets it just wide, Zero with the follow-up, keeps it in the blue zone, but it's cleared out in the end nicely by Kawhi. The reply, though, gets it stopped in the midfield. Aura Crow carries it into the orange zone. The ball sitting up now. Kawhi gets up into the air. The joust is a bit of a whiff from both teams. Whoa. Zero flying past. And still donuts on the board. No early goals this time round, Byza.
Yeah, no early goals right now, but we're just saying that it's sitting and attacking for the boys on the 0.1 hit ratio, and they're keeping it there, mounting the pressure. Two-Face pushes out for his side. Dumbo around the corner, just sits in the middle on that wing. Kawhi will jump up and try and work it into the favor for his team, sets it to the middle. Xera with an open shot, shoots, almost scores. Aura Crow from about 30 out, saves it, and that's a really good play by him. But they're now playing defense here, 0.1, and they've got to work out and try and get around the Ducks defense.
Yeah, Kawhi gets a touch on it, tries to carry the ball forward along the ground. Good defense though, and straight away it's returned back into the blue zone. There, it seems the way these games are going, Byza, one team seems to just take control and start to maintain pressure by keeping the ball in the zone. Oh! Two-Face with a great carry, and Aura Crow with an equally good defense. The ball still sitting up, floating past the blue goal. No scores, still donuts on the board for all of them. Dumbo with a long range, a shot on goals from the clear there, but still no score. The ball sitting up, a great little touch there from Dumbo. Aura Crow with a follow through on defense. But the blue zone is where the ball still is. Just no power. And the angles, Byza, are just not right for either of these two teams to break the donut.
I think the team captain for the Mighty Ducks has had a little bit of a pep talk because they've stepped up their game. Attack on goal is first rate right now. And it's just, they can't get it past the strong defense of 0.1. And that's the story. If they can't get the goal in the next minute, it's going to be tough. And they'll go three down. Down three games in the series and have to do it all on the back end, you know?
Very, very difficult to come back from that. A bit of flashiness from Kawhi Neku Waifu up in the air to win that aerial joust. But winning the joust being pretty not good enough. The ball's got to go into the back of the net. And look at that. For an age, the orange goal was wide open. No defenders there. But the shot's just not on target from the 10%ers.
Oh,
Schnoot shoots and gets the ball in. Breaks the deadlock. Gets himself and his team on the board again. And the Mighty Ducks are in with the chance to take the game.
Chance nicely done. Works out the side. He had his teammate, Xera, lining up with him. So that was pretty much a guaranteed Ducks goal. And just as we were talking before, the Ducks get themselves in ahead. But this game's, and the games, as you see before on the scoreboard, it's been high scoring. So we're definitely
great
not
touch.
Going to see the last goals.
Oh, it didn't go in. Oh, Aura Crow with a touch that was so close. It was.
Oh, almost another. Dumbo almost doing the same. The peppering from 0.1. Absolutely going crazy at the moment. Aurora tries to set into the side. Xera sitting on the wall. He needs to get back to goals and try and save it for at the moment. But it drops down. Two-Faced sort of doing a little bit of a fake out. And now we've got the ball stuck in limbo in the middle. Yeah. And the guy's not knowing what to do. Now goes into the attack. Hits back out. Schnatz. This is the Ducks' turn to try and put something on the board once again. It goes out to the side. Xera sits up on the wall. Tries to pop. But the Kawhi is setting it up for his team here. Crisis. And this is 0.1 being dangerous right now.
Yeah, we're following Zero at the moment. He is the last man standing on defense, hanging around his own goal face there, watching Two-Face just miss the bounce there, goes up to get the clear in. Schnatz was there to support him, but that's two defenders that have been cleared away, and another shot goes wide yet again. So Zero takes his opportunity, carries the ball up, waits for it to come to him, sets it up. This might be a solo effort. No, Kawhi is there to disrupt and to prevent the ball from going in. Well, he gets the ball cleared away, and now it's in the midfield. It is 1-0 to the Mighty Ducks with 30 seconds to go, Byza.
Oh, this is a tough game right now. The intensity is top notch, and both teams working overtime to try and get a conversion on the score. 0.1 hit ratio up behind, and they're trying everything. They're pulling every single trick out as the defense comes from Xera. It's on target, 10 seconds are ticking on the clock. He tail whips it, trying to get an advantage for his team, but it's more of a deflection just to count down that clock. Schnatz hits it up again. Last opportunity for 0.1. Two-Face will put it straight into the dirt, and there is a Ducks with a round, and they bring that back for the team. 0.1, well, wow, that's tough, Crisis. Absolutely tough at the moment, but we see a level of the series, and this is some crazy action going on right now.
Oh, man, I tell you what, tomorrow night we're going to be covering the Invite Division Finals, and if they produce the kind of action that we're seeing tonight, well, we will be lucky to get it two nights in a row. Two all the series tied up between the Mighty Ducks and the 10 percenters. I suppose the difference that you'd expect, Byza, from the Invite League is not so many shots of goal going wide.
Well, you'd see a lot more defensive structure, hit-outs and setups, and a lot more team pass play. It's crazy. EJ, what's the social media like right now? I'm sure it's a buzz.
Yeah, it is, dude. We're just chatting to some of our European viewers who are tuning in tonight, and they're saying the commentators are just as high quality, if not better, than anything out of the EU or the USA.
Oh, that's fantastic. There's a shot from Zero. Zero scores while we're patting ourselves on the back. The ball sitting up, and he controls it onto the ground. It's got so much power, you've got to boost all the way to catch up with it, and that's what he does. Our replay doesn't even see the goal. He knew that it was going in. And for the Mighty Ducks, that is 1-0, and they have some real momentum now, Byza.
We're seeing the teams tonight. It's sort of a trend on when the ball usually is just in the middle at the start of the center bounces. That's when your defenses are not set and you don't have the boost. It's the best opportunity to score for a goal. But if you don't put the goal in the back of the net, it's just as easy just to get the rebound and have the ball
Kawhi
go down the
just
as quickly.
Yeah, I'm just saying Kawhi might have beaten his own player there with the juggle against the wall, but fortunately the ball crosses the goal face and doesn't get powered in by the Mighty Ducks, so he manages to get away with that. The orange zone is briefly visited by the ball, but again the blue zone visited by Mighty Ducks. The ball there, Dumbo gets a great work, does great work combining with Kawhi to carry the ball through, but buys it back and forth as with every other game so far. But just as I say that, Two-Face comes through, turtles himself across the field after scoring that. It was Two-Face that scored the ball.
Yeah, that is the most random goal scene of the night. He's hit it into the opposition, and as he's hitting the opposition, he's flipped the car, and it's gone up, dropped down, and Xera's missed it, obviously, because he was flying. But that's his goal, and that's the most random thing I've seen all night. As they go into the attack, it's an open goal for the man of Xera, but he misses the ball in the process and cannot score. Schnutz follows up and tries to set something up, but now it's a 0.1 hit ratio in the attacking line. Kawhi tries to beat out his player, goes wide. Dumbo waiting for it. Schnutz will hit out for the Ducks and try and set something for his team, but comes back around. That is the Kawhi with the center. Two-Face and Oroko with the center. Jow's dropping down. Dumbo trying to set something up. Still really dangerous for both teams here, Crisis, but at the moment the Ducks are in the lead and they want to hold on to it.
Yeah, and they've got a nice little margin. It's not quite enough to go to sleep, but with 3 minutes to go, they've scored the only two goals of the game, and more importantly, they scored the only goal of the previous game. So momentum thoroughly on their side right now, and the pressure onto the 10 percenters. Can they change the run of play, or is this going to be another game going towards the Mighty Ducks and them setting themselves up for a possibility at a match point game?
Now, both teams are really good. And did we say the Mighty Ducks beat 0.1 hit ratio in the season?
I think they did. Let me just check my notes.
I've got to find my notes. I think they're mine. 2-1 losses. No.
Yeah,
that was Elim Gaming. It was Elim Gaming. So look, the Mighty Ducks haven't had a chance to beat Zero.
Shot on goals.
So this would be really good to set in their psyche, as the goal's almost shot by Kawhi. In fact, he saved it. One of the Mighty Ducks. I'm getting lost at the moment. This is how intense this game is. It's catching me a little bit off guard here, Chrisis.
Another shot that goes wide, and this has been the pattern of play all evening long. The shots keep coming, but none of them go in. Look at that. Three shots taken by Blue, with four shots taken by the Mighty Ducks on Orange. And yeah, it's just not converting. The percentages are not there for, well, for the 10 percenters, but at the very least, or at least for the Mighty Ducks, they've been able to pick up two goals themselves. Danger now as the ball sits in the orange zone. Kawhi keeps it there. Orokro looking to take advantage of the angle.
Oh, this
gets
is dangerous.
It towards the goal. It's sitting up, but Kawhi Neku just out of position and can't put it away. Gets butted in the backside by Dumbo, but Schnutz is there Dumbo to get the clear out.
Dumbo doing a little bit of get out of my way type of
thing. Oh! I mean,
wowee. I see. Look at this. Kawhi from the center. Oh, wow. Wow, that's some style points, too. What a lovely goal. What a way to get yourself onto the scoreboard. 0.1 hit ratio, Chrisis. Break their deadlock. They're now the one. They're back in this game. Don't count them out yet because there's still a minute left to play.
Just a minute, and that is a long time in Rocket League. And now Dumbo gets the ball forward. He goes up into the air. He's got another shot on. Maybe that's the momentum turning in favor of the 10 percenters. But the ball sitting in the orange zone for a little while and then getting cleared out nicely. Dumbo, we're sticking with him as the ball gets carried up by Orokro up off the wall. Dumbo gets himself into the air. Is the ping going to be hurting him tonight? No, it doesn't. It's sitting in the blue zone. I mean, sorry, in the orange zone. But no aggression really from the boys on 10%. Now Dumbo gets a shot towards the goal, but it doesn't go in. It's easily defended and back into the orange zone. It's sitting up. Three players there. Who's going to score?
No.
The defense from Schnutz. Oh, my God. And I've almost lost my voice there with an incredible defense there. And it's not over just yet. They still keep on going. I've got to take a break. Catch my breath.
We've got two more matches, and you cannot lose your voice right now, Chrisis. Oh, my goodness. That was all 0.1 hit ratio. It was all them in the last minute of that game, and they could not convert. Story of the night is the Mighty Ducks come from behind right now, and they're in front, and they've got the advantage. Oh, my goodness. I'm going to update that scoreboard as EJ gets an update for what's going on in the Twitch chat.
They're talking about the prizes that are up for grabs tonight. So five headsets going out and about $2,225 according to the post here for the CGM.
2,000?
Wow, that's what it says. No, maybe not. Maybe $2.
First place gets $2,253.
Well, that can't be right.
No, it's 200 and something.
But they do get headsets. Who doesn't love a headset?
Yeah. All right. So shout out to Plantronics who have provided the prizes for tonight. Of course, they've provided the prizes for all of the finals series, the amateur, the main division, and the invite division, which will be happening tomorrow. But goodness me, man, that was the ball just not wanting to go into the back of the net for the 10 percenters. They had their chances and they were just not able to take it. And now the pressure is on for them to come back and prevent a six-game victory in favor of the Mighty Ducks.
225 and three headsets, by the way.
225 each.
Yeah.
So it's 225 times three.
That's the total price.
Oh.
I got a shout-out from Spra. 225 for the winner with three Plantronics gaming headsets, and the second gets $135 of prize money.
Rightio. So that's cleared up then.
We're sorted.
Good stuff. So Dumbo now carrying...
Shout out to Pandan, by the way, tuning in. Haven't chatted for a long time. Hey. And shout out to Pandan.
Shout out to Pandan, indeed. Hit that follow button on Gamester TV 1, Pandan. You'll get more Gamester action coming your way. Up into the air goes Dumbo. Looks for an attempt on goals off of the wall, but it's not to be. We're with zero right now. He's flown past the ball as now once again... The ball sitting in a zone, sitting in front of a goal face, and nobody punching it in and scoring. It's donuts on the ball, Byza, at the one-minute mark.
I think the boys are just taking a little bit of a breather, trying to set up their attacks. As the shot comes, I always say that, and the goal's converted, but in this case, nothing happening for the teams. Here comes the Ducks with an attack, hits the side. It's in positional, favorable positional for a player, but no one is coming through to have a shot. It's more the defense from the 0.1 hit ratio. Now that's back in their half, Dumbo has to try and work. He does a little bit of dribble and pops up. Snuts reading it very well. Hits it to the side, bounces off. Ororoco's matched to the occasion and tries to do the work. Zero coming through, almost a shot. Hits the top and bounces back out. Snuts is not finished with it. He has a shot. Oh, Kawhi with a save. And I sort of went girly right there because that was an epic save. And just holds on because that could have been the goal for the Ducks early on here, Crosses.
It was because it was Kawhi Nekuwaifu. Tilt of the head. 3 minutes is the counter. 3 minutes of play remaining as Dumbo carries the ball forward, gets a good bounce to himself off of the net. He defends, he carries the ball and keeps control of it, but he's carried it all the way over to the midfield and set it up for Mighty Ducks to push it over into the blue zone. And a great goal from Two-Face, gets up into the air and pushes it down, gets the spike down, and beats Orocro in the goals.
Lovely with that. Yeah, nice shot there. And chat, Dom Mega, trolling me hard styles on Twitch chat. Thanks, mate. Back later.
2:38 on the clock, and once again, the Mighty Ducks are in the lead, 1-0. Of course, they're in the lead with 3-2 over the 10 percenters. Who, I remind you, are the favorite, are the top seed tonight, the 10 percenters. This is number one seed versus number two seed. And right now, the number two seed are in the lead and in control of the finals. But Byza, it's not over. If whoever gets knocked out of this game isn't knocked out of the competition, they still have a second chance and then a third chance, in fact. So, look, they can beat Elim Gaming if they lose here and get themselves into the grand final and redeem themselves.
And what you mean by third chance is moving progression through to the grand final. That's what it means by third chance.
Yeah. You know what I mean.
just to clarify, it's not a triple Elim. Yes, indeed. Well, I'll tell you now, the Ducks are in front. There's a minute and 45 seconds ticking. If anything goes for the story tonight, there was a lot of goals scored. But the last couple of games, the goals have dried up and it's tightened. So this might be the scoreline, that might be the result at the end. I don't know. We'll see. But the Ducks at the moment are putting the pressure on 0.1. Just rebounding out now. Kawhi sets it to the middle. It's lining up for a goal. Shot. The defensive hit out from Two-Face sorts it out for his team. But it's coming back very quickly. Dumbo following it. Two-Face will try and clear it past him. Kawhi also setting up, now dropping high. This is dangerous. No one's stopping the end goal. It's floating. Orocro is coming in from the side. Slow motion, smack in, smack down, whatever you want to call it. That is a beautiful goal from the Orocro. And they're back on the board here, Crisis. Lovely play from 0.1 hit ratio.
Yeah, great touch there from Orocro to even up the scores with 1 minute and 10 seconds remaining. It is wide open right now, but the pressure is still on the 10 percenters because they are the ones who are behind in the round score. So they've evened things up. They have to score another goal. If it's not in the next minute, it's got to be the overtime goal for them to stay in
Dumbo!
This match. A great effort off the wall from Dumbo.
You've got to have a look at Two-Face. He's sitting the goalie. He's ran up the wall and he stuffed himself. Take nothing away from Dumbo. It's a fantastic shot. Two-Face is not what you're going to do at this time of the game. Oh, no.
Oh, dear. 54 seconds remaining, Byza. And the Mighty Ducks go down. It is now the 10%ers game to win.
Yes. Yes, indeed. It's 40, like you said, 40 seconds ticking. Look, 0.1, they take this away. We go into seven. We go into the seventh game. And we've already seen a round of seven tonight. And we're going to the second lot. It's set up for some crazy action. 30 seconds down on the clock. It is in a defensive half for the Mighty Ducks. But here comes Xera. The deflection coming from Dumbo will work it out to the side. Orocro also there with him. But the player in Two-Face sets to the side. And for some reason, hits it back to the defensive side. Maybe it was a call to go, hey, hit it back. Let's hit it forward again. But it sort of set the Ducks out of the range. Last ditch shot coming from Xero. The second follow-up not there. The ball is in a dispute in sort of the central limbo as Kawhi hits it down to the side and that ticks down. 0.1 hit ratio or your 10 percenters pick up the game and we're moving to the seventh game, Crisis. what a game that turned out to be, and what a series this is turning out to be right now.
Very, very low scoring, but full of action nevertheless, as the best of seven format. Look, if this was, let's have a look here. If this was a best of five, it would have been over.
It would have been the Ducks. Ducks would have taken it home.
Yeah, the Ducks would have taken it home. Because they won game number two, game number three. They won game number... No, sorry, I'm just getting myself all twisted. So they would have won if it was a best of five.
They would have won.
And the best of seven proves itself very, very valuable to the 10 percenters.
Now, while we're waiting for the boys just to sort out what's going on, I think Schnutz has left, so it looks like we're probably going to have to reset this here, Crisis.
I can give you a quick social media update then.
While you do that in a sec, also, let's get the guys to put out the MVP. Think about the MVP and who you want to vote for this match, because it's quite crazy at the moment, EJ.
Well, the highlight in the social media during that last round was Byza getting trolled by Don Mega.
That was honestly Don Mega still out as well.
feel like a little girl. Yeah, righto.
So there's
and
a question.
And we like all Bogans who are watching to also press the subscribe button. We love Bogans.
Shout out to our international viewers. Thank you for coming
like
in and watching this. And
hit the subscribe button too, Byza.
Yeah. And you know what? You know what would be even better? Give the link out to your mates. Let's get some more people in here, because the more interaction we can get with you guys, the better.
I'd even like it if your mum had hit the subscribe button. That'll even be good.
It's not my mum.
I'm not going anywhere near Byza's mum.
I was just waiting for it. No. Oh, man, I was waiting for something to happen there, but thank goodness it didn't.
If you know me at all, I'm no good with comebacks, and so I can't. I'll just leave it open. I'll just dig the grave.
Shout out to Turbo Pulsar, who is not from the Oceanic region, I think, asking if anybody played the predecessor to Rocket League, SARP, or whatever the acronym sounds like. Super,
okay.
Super whatever. Super acrobatic rocket cars or something like that. No, nobody's played it. So everybody started with this game about 3 months ago and have thrown hundreds and hundreds of hours at it. And this is the result of it. This is, of course, the second division. We're going to have the invite division at the same time tomorrow night, as we have a little bit of a false start here. Zera is calling for a game crash. And I think that means we're going to have to leave the server, Byza.
Yeah, I've left the server, so I'm sitting back in the lobby. One of the guys has dropped out. Schnutz has disconnected, so we've got to wait for him to come back, and then we'll get the round 7 underway. Well, I'll tell you what, just recapping over the whole lot, we're going back and forth. 0.1 ratio have shown how strong they can be early game, but, you know, all Ducks fans and the way the Ducks work, especially, you know, in the cult hero that is the Mighty Ducks, they come back. And they come back strong. So, you know, they've picked up the last two. They've lost that one. We could see a really intense final game and even a big overtime period in this one, Crisis.
Shout out again to Turbo Pulsar. Yes, mate, you're famous. And you can certainly expect to start getting messages in Skype from women who just want to get to know you. And give you lovely links to all sorts of fantastic websites that they want you to have a look at. Shout out to Soma, who is in the Twitch chat as well, and he is Soma, the head admin of the Rocket League, whatever's area, I guess, the Rocket League community at CyberGamer, and has done a fantastic piece of work together with the other admins and the refs in the first season of the Plantronics Pro League. Speaking of admins and refs...
Shout out to Dogpa. Shout out to Dogpa, sorry. Tinder Eagles GameStar confirmed.
you don't swipe and, left me, I'm happy.
And also, shout out to Humspa with the hashtag Bab Family and Favorite Mayonnaise. There you go.
Okay, random, we are back in the server. And let's see if I can... get my spectator mode sorted out. If anybody from Psyonix has joined us, to get some cracker Oceanic Region Rocket League. Notice how you've put the scores for the orange team on the right-hand side, but the camera always starts with the orange team on the left-hand side. And
Chrisis is a little bit anal with that, but yeah, OCD anal, whatever you want to call it. It's the same thing as we get the final game for this finals action for Plantronics, all down in pat, ready to go. The first demo there with the Kauai, and at the moment, both teams looking to put a score on the board here, Chrisis.
Yeah, who's going to get an early goal, if anyone, is the big question. This is the final game of the best of seven. That's another shot that goes wide. It's been happening all night. Schnutz takes a shot and doesn't get it through. I'm sorry. You see what's happened?
You make me laugh every time you call that. Like, every time you say that, you make me laugh. It was the opportunity for a goal goes begging for the Ducks. But look, I think the guys, we just had a little bit of a dropout. Shout out to Kauai. He's actually
shot
of
goals.
Dumbo
does the work. Does the business. The ball put up into the air by Orocro, and he gets the angle that beats the defender, and that is a sub 1 minute goal, and we've had a couple of those today, but certainly not in the previous two games. So maybe we're in for a good bunch of let's see if we get a hat trick in this or in this goal at least, Byza.
Well, we haven't seen any of the players get a hat trick, but no. It's possible, but I think they'd like to share the load. Everyone is equally as good in this main division, division number two. And we actually have the invite, the division number one, tomorrow night. So if you are tuning in from overseas, internationally, make sure you tune in at the same time tomorrow night, because we have even better players. But hey, don't go away yet. Here comes the shot for Kauai, and it's in! And the hit, 0.1 hit ratio, put a second one in, and they're just confirming their stakes on this match and wanting to hit into the grand final here at Chrisis.
Yeah, doing a good job. It is 2-0. The donut's still on the board for the Mighty Ducks. The momentum truly broken from the middle of the series where they seem to be in control. A shot on goals from Schnutz as he shoots. Gets through.
Gets to the Schnutz. We went there.
Look at these players who don't like to play with ball cam. And for some reason, there you go, my camera shake is on, so I'm going to just try and switch it off there.
Because we have to reset. Oops. No, don't leave the match. That would be quite sad for the viewers, because we're in the final one at the moment. The score is in the favor of 0.1 hit ratio, 2-1 as the timer ticks down, 13 minutes and 10. Fly coming from the Skittles. And hold on. We've had a sub. I didn't pick that up. We've had a sub.
Oh, Skittles is in.
We've lost zero.
Yeah, we've lost zero. No. Zero is still in.
No.
Schnutz, zero. And who was the other player that was doing so well? Somebody in the Twitch chat, tell us.
Oh, lost. Yeah. Well, we got a sub in, which is different. So this might be all it takes is for the sub. But at the moment, he doesn't have the six games play under him. But he probably doesn't have that stress either. He's sitting in the middle at the moment, forcing himself back. Schnutz working the side up the
Two-face.
Wall as well, centers it up. Is it Two-Face?
Yes, Two-Face, that's disappeared. No. He's actually been subbed out. Skittles is in as a substitute. So the starting lineup for the Mighty Ducks has been disrupted. And I wonder if this is because Two-Face was having issues or if Skittles is their secret weapon. But it hasn't really worked out for them just yet, Byza, because they are 2-1 down. But maybe he comes into the game. So let's give him a little bit of airtime as he heads on over wide to pick up a little bit of boost. He's defending in the orange zone right now. Gets up off the wall. Gets a good touch on it. Gets a second touch
nice.
On it. Crosses it over. But it's Kauai Neku who... Kauai Neku Waifu. Oh. He gets a touch and disrupts it. Gets it back into the orange zone.
Too much gas for Orocro as he tried to come through for a setup shot.
Shot and goals, it's good!
Over the top! Oh, gets Dumbo slotting in a lovely one over the top. Have a look at this shot, pass from Kauai. Goes straight up and pops it over. Oh, Xera, couldn't do much about that. And they confirm that they've gone up a little bit more here. 3-1 in the favor of the hit ratio team. With a minute and 40 seconds, Chrisis, there's still enough time for the Ducks, but it's getting tough.
Whoa, that was a powerful shot. Schnutz gets the save in there. And he will be very, very pleased with that. The Mighty Ducks coming very close to getting the deficit down to just one with that shot. But it's not to be. The ball crosses over the face. Dumbo on defense gets the clear out. Now the ball over into the orange zone. So Mighty Ducks back on defense. Dumbo carries the ball forward. It gets a shot on. Oh, it's off the side, off the post, and doesn't go in. It's still 3-1, but it could have been 4, Byza.
Yeah, they're really dangerous at the moment, and I think it's just I reckon it's almost a missed opportunity that Skittles, well, that the Ducks have come in, and well, trying to figure out what I'm saying here. Skittles has come in. He's not matched warmed, and this is where hit one ratio has start to dominate, because they've got a not warmed up player who's not clearing out well.
Yeah, and there you just saw it right then. Instead of going up for the joust, he just watched Orochro go up, and it was really up to Orochro to make a shot. And fortunately for Skittles, he didn't. Fortunately for the Mighty Ducks, Orochro just went for the rebound instead of the shot. Now the ball crossing over again. Good interception there by Schnutz, but it's still in the orange zone. Schnutz again with a second touch, gets it out. Zero with a good touch, but an excellent defense there. Oh, that was just excellent. And he didn't even get a halo for that because of the angle. The winner goes to 0.1 hit ratio. Time ran out in the end there. In fact, I lost track of time completely. And it's the 10%ers who win and push the Mighty Ducks, Byza, down into the elimination final.
Who was your MVP, guys? Any standouts in that particular game?
All right, well, for me, I think Kawhi Neko Waifu. I mean, he scored.
Yeah.
He only scored.
I'm also there with Dumbo.
So
Dumbo played pretty well. Yep.
Oh, game of chokes, says Orochro. And I think he's probably speaking for himself, because if you look at the score there in the mid-game, mid-series, they really fell off and let the Mighty Ducks back in after going up 2-1 in the lead. So they might feel very lucky that they managed to get through and book themselves a berth in the grand final with just a single series.
It's an amazing work by 0.1 hit ratio. A lot of the momentum was with the Ducks coming in the mid rounds, and it almost take it, but they just lost it in the end there. And I think the dropout of your core member, as you're heavily into the
that
series,
yeah,
that was probably a deciding factor on the end there. And you just saw 0.1 hit ratio to pepper the hell out of that goal. And Ducks, they couldn't do much. And don't take anything away from Skittles. He come in at the worst time, but he did as best as he could. But he's just not warmed up and not in that pressure.
You'll see the best of Skittles in the losers bracket now. He's had his warm-up, so Skittles to step up.
Mm, indeed.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, so we have two MVP candidates so far for the night. In the first game, from Elim Gaming, the school bus, and in the second game, from 0.1 hit ratio, the number one seeded team, Dumbo, put forward for the match MVP. We will be right back in just a couple of minutes. We're going to get set up for the elimination final, which, of course, is going to see both the Mighty Ducks and Elim Gaming return to GameStar TV to fight for a place in the grand final. This is Chrisis. Byza and EJ, just for now, signing out. Stay tuned.